Hey, everybody, Z Garcia here, and today we're taking a look at the expansion to the treasure-finding game Tobago. This is Volcano. Tobago, the original board game, is a very cool game in which you are, all the players are going to be collectively putting together clues as to where there is treasure, and then racing each other to drive their little ATVs to that spot, dig up that treasure, and split it among the clue givers. It's very neat, a very strange little quirky game, gorgeous production, and it's also not very new. It's over a decade old at this point, I think. So I was very surprised to see that there was an expansion for it. I was not expecting one, but there is an expansion for it, called Volcano, which introduces, strangely enough, a volcano. Really cool one, too, because it is this neat 3D thing that's going to go on the board and spew lava from it, and you'll be covering up the board in some lava tiles. I am going to assume for this video that you know Tobago, that you understand how the game works, that you remember what it looks like and how it plays, because while the board will be in the shot, I'm not explaining the original game. I'm just giving you the differences from that original game to what the Volcano expansion will now introduce, all right? So if you're all set up and you don't need to catch up on that video, if you do, go check it out. But if not, let's go ahead and dive right in. All right, so let's talk about the differences that the expansion is going to bring to the game of Tobago. The first thing is starting places on the island are going to be a little bit different. You're setting up basically everything else the same, but you're going to put the volcano somewhere in the center of the board. It doesn't really matter that much where you put it. And in fact, in the rule book, they say once you've played a few times, you can kind of mess with where this goes. But it makes those spaces impassable, of course, and lava might flow from this volcano depending on how the players play that out. And then there's these, okay? There's going to be four of these, and you are going to give one to each player, or they can draft them. You can do this however you want to. And then these are going to be placed around the island, and there will be the new starting locations for the players. Here's how it works. So let's say I am blue, and I take this one, or I am given this one. I have to put it somewhere where one of the types of spaces lines up with another one of that same type. The other one has to be covered up with the lava tile, and then the other one, the normal space, is going to extend the board, so it'll be over the ocean. So I could put that there, for example. I could put it over here if I want to, where I do something like this. Let's see, or I could flip it over actually also, and I could put this one here. So I could do that, mountain on mountain, lava covering up that, and then a new space that shows up out here. And on that space is where you are going to start, okay? So that's the first thing. Any that are not used, because you have fewer than four players, you can just return those to the box and they are not going to be used for the game. Other than that, the four spaces that have lava, beginning spaces, or three or two, however many players you have, they are normally not passable. And more lava is going to show up as the players are picking up these amulets, okay? So the building up a clue as to where a treasure is, racing out there to go pick it up, that all behaves the same way. And then these will show up where the statues are pointing. Same deal. If the last place something is pointing at would be lava, it just shows up right before that on the, the closest place that to the lava that isn't lava yet anyway. And so once you've done that, and the statues see right through the volcano, by the way, you, of course, rotate them, do all that. As players are picking these up, every time you pick up an amulet, you are going to grab one of these lava tiles and you add it to the board. It has to go either next to the volcano or next to lava that's already in play. So I could put it there, okay? If it goes somewhere that has a tree or a hut, those are going to be burned down and removed from the game. They cannot go where the statues are, and of course they cannot go into the volcano spaces, but of course they can be coming out of the volcano like that, all right? There's these over here. These four are going to be new permanent clues as to where treasure might be, and these are cardboard tiles instead of being just a card, but they basically behave the same way that these clue cards do. The way to play these is, if you are adding a card to a clue, you can, instead of adding a card that diminishes the possible range, meaning a legal card placement, if you place an illegal card placement, for example, one says next to a statue, such as this one, if you have a card in your hand that says not next to a statue, which would be an illegal placement right there, you can play it there at that clue and then immediately cover it with one of these available on the side. And then you mark it. And this is going to be one of two different kinds of things. Next to or not next to the volcano. And then same thing for lava. Next to or not next to any lava tile. Then you check what's a legal placement. Once this is done, once that treasure has been divvied out, then you'll take the tile and place it back over here next to the board so that it is available for the players again. You obviously cannot take one if it is currently part of the clues as to where one of the treasures is. So that's another difference there. Other than that, most everything is the same. There's one new usage for the amulets, and that is to cross lava. So let's go ahead and set up a little lava example here, like this, and then let's say we put lava there too, so that tree burnt up. Just melted. So there we go, and let's say I want to get somewhere over here with that blue one. Well, on your turn, you can spend an amulet to traverse lava, but you have to start off of it, and you have to end off of it. So I could cash one in and take my three legs, where I'll go one, two, and then three. And that would be, again, at the cost of one amulet, I can traverse that. You might find that necessary if you are surrounded by it and you have to get out. And if you find yourself in that situation and you don't have an amulet to give up, then you can still get out by discarding your highest treasure, which is pretty penalizing, but that's a new dynamic in the game, the idea of being careful not to get trapped behind the lava flow and therefore isolated from where the action is happening, which is, you know, again, a very dynamic and new addition to the game. So that's pretty much the game flow. That's the new way it's going to work out. The end game trigger is still the same. You are going to finish divvying out all the cards and then figure out who's got the most treasure. The one thing I do want to mention here, because I'll be talking about it a decent amount up top, is that as lava is being added to the board, these areas are going to be changing, of course, because anything you cover up no longer counts. You might even split something, right? Like if lava is ever added here and here, let's say, then you now have two new forests. This one made up of five and this one made up of two. And if you add another one here, then now same thing, but now this one's made up of four, which might make it no longer the largest, no longer the smallest, things like that. And so every time you add a tile that has lava on it, you have to recheck that all of the clues so far are correct, that they're still pointing to the same thing. So you need to look at all the clues, look at where the cubes have been placed on the board and figure out this is no longer right, right? Especially when, say, a hut is burnt down. You're going, well, it says it's next to a hut, so none of these are now legal anymore or not next to a hut, and some of them are newly legal. That's something to be aware of, and you have to check it again every single time a new lava tile is added to the board to make sure everything is still going correctly. It's even possible for all the clues to get burnt up and that whole treasure just vanishes, and you have to just remove all the clues, start a new treasure hunt. So there it is, everybody. Let's go ahead and go back up top. Let me tell you what I think of it. That's Tobago Volcano, which is kind of fun to say. Alright, so overall I like this expansion. I think it's a pretty good one. It is perhaps a little underwhelming because it's been so long since the game came out, okay? It is not modular. It's basically one module, if you want to think of it that way. And there is a little less in the box than the size of the box would have led me to believe. But overall, I do like it. Let's dive into it. Theme at the top. I like what this adds. The volcano is going to add a nice evolving look, a nice amount of sort of, again, evolving pressure to the game. Thematically, it really works. It makes the island more interesting, a bigger threat. Really, the players are the threat, but you know what I mean. And so I like everything that it introduces. The game was quite a mellow game originally. I think with the Volcano expansion thrown in, it does ratchet up the tension of what's happening in your surroundings. Okay, the aesthetics. Very good. The original game is stunning, of course. But the components here do fit right in. The Volcano piece, as I said, is very nice. Lava tiles, good quality. Same as the original cardboard quality, no problem there. And then these are nice and sturdy. Just, you know, same stuff. Nice cardboard tiles. Rulebook is good. It works out well. I still wish they would have taken a chance in the expansion here to give the players a player aid that includes what you can do with the amulets. It's one of those things that I wish would have been in the original game. You know, a little, just a card per player that says, here's what you can do with the amulets. You can cash it in to discard your hand and draw a new hand. You can cash it in to play an extra clue, whatever. This would have been a great opportunity for that because there's a new thing you can do, traverse the lava. So I feel like that's a small missed opportunity, and it's apparent because there aren't a lot of things in the box. Giant Volcano piece, 4 of these triangular ones, right? It's the giant Volcano, 4 of these, a bunch of lava tiles, and the 4 things, the 4 tiles over there with the clues. That's it. So it kind of stands out that it isn't there, but it looks good. The box is just too big for what's in there. Replay value, I think it's fine. Again, I'm looking at only the replay value as from the base game, which I think is good, okay? I'm looking at the replay value added by this. I think it's fine. It's going to add some more interaction between the players is the main thing it's going to do. And you have to decide how much you like that, I think. And there are some things that it introduces while taking a few other things away that I'll talk about in a second. But yes, the game is a little bit, quote-unquote, meaner now. You can sort of mess with people, block them off, force them to go the long way around something. So that is there. The game didn't feel as confrontational before. It was pretty relaxed, kind of laid back. You're still fighting for the treasure, but it didn't seem as directly confrontational. It's not terrible. I don't want to make it sound like now this is a take-that game where you throw down the gauntlet every time you play. That's not quite it. But it is definitely more confrontational. Has the replayability gone up? Well, yeah, you can play with the expansion or without it. Inherently, most expansions are going to give you more replayability. Is one game with the Volcano very, very different from the next one? Yeah, as different as the game originally was because the boards were double-sided and you could kind of make it however you wanted to. I think, again, it adds replayability. It's not getting a negative here. But it isn't suddenly mind-blowing. It's just a means to an end, the lava, to mess with each other and kind of poke the other players. So I like it. It's fine. The game arc, I think, is very good. Again, because of the visual appeal of it all evolving and because while the clock in the game isn't really the lava, it's still this deck of cards over here, and not that one, that one. And when this runs out, that's when the game is over, the treasure pile. It sort of tricks your mind into thinking, ooh, I hope we finish the game before this whole island burns down. And so the tension and the fear of being cut off or being near what you need to be near does rise. And it's a very true thing. You might be stuck on the wrong side of the island when a couple of people pick up some amulets and throw some lava in your way, and suddenly, oh, you're not going to get anywhere near that treasure. You got to give up on that one. So, game arc is good. The ease of play is my big hit here for basically one main thing. Again, this doesn't add a whole lot, but what it does add is very dynamic and interesting and comes hand in hand with a lot of rules checking and fiddliness. The idea of the changing land sizes forcing you to constantly recheck that something is still legal, that something can still be dug up, that those cubes that you placed as your clue waypoints are still where the thing is. So that's a little annoying, and I understand that it has to be the way it is, I just find it inelegant. And everything in this game, everything else in this game, is so elegant that that one thing really stands out. The sort of constant upkeep every time those are dug up. So, yeah, that's my main issue there. If it was that one rule among many other rules, I might be a little less sort of hung up on it. But there's only, like, three new rules, you know? And they're a little fiddlier than I wish they were. I mean, there's, like, the rule book is only, like, six pages, I want to say. And literally two solid pages of those are dedicated to how you deal with this. When something is no longer the largest, when something is split in two, when two things are tied for being the largest. All of that. And I get it. You know, it has to be that way. Lastly, tactics, luck, strategy. With those annoying rules come hand in hand some really neat new things you can do. You can now change where something would have come up by breaking up a chunk of land. If your opponent is across the map, near the closest forest, you can destroy that forest by, splitting it in two. Neither one of those is any longer the biggest one. And now all the clues that would have popped up over there, you have to recheck where they go, and now suddenly, boop, boop, they're over here. That's neat. I like the ability to do that. It's a sort of roundabout way to smack somebody and be like, you're in the wrong place, you're on the wrong trail. So strategically and sort of tactically, really, it's fun. I also like these. They work fine. At first I thought, is this needed? It seems like such a counterintuitive thing. You have to play a rule that's illegal, cover it up. Yes, it's needed. Yes, it makes sense and works well. In practice, it comes up and you will use them, okay? So there you go. Overall, I don't want to sound too harsh on this one because I do like it. I guess it's just I'm slightly underwhelmed because the game has been out for a long time. It's so gorgeous. And instead of getting new maps or new cards or, you know, something like that, it's just the Volcano, which kind of feels like a module in a box that maybe should have had like three modules. Where's my unique player powers? Where's my, you know, those sorts of things? That's just not in here. So there you go. Still like it, though, and this is going to get, from me, a 7.5 out of 10, which is a seal of approval. It's not as high as I rate the game, which I think is fantastic, but it's not a bad expansion by any means. If you play this game a lot, or you just want to revitalize it, you know, you want to bring it back to the table, you were always hoping for a little more interactivity between the players, this will definitely give you that. So, Tobago Volcano, 7.5 out of 10. My name is Z Garcia, everybody. Thanks for checking this out. I'll see you on the next one.